Today is World Water Day, a day which has particular significance here in the Middle East, where scarcity of fresh water is a persistent concern. To talk more about that, we're joined by Miret Mabrouk, Senior Fellow and Founding Director of the Egypt Programme at the Middle East Institute. Great to have you with us. Thank you very much for joining us. And first of all, how serious is the situation regarding water scarcity in the MENA region, and which countries are worst affected?
Right. So the situation is extremely serious. Even countries that you would think have access to water, Egypt, for example, Egypt's Nile Delta, that's actually only about 3% of the country's land mass. So the area, very few of the countries in the region have access to water. The problems disproportionately affect women and children. In fact, about 90% of the children in the area live in areas of high stress or extremely high stress water. Of the top 10 countries in the world that are most water stressed, the Middle East has five. I think it's Lebanon, Syria, Iraq, Turkey, and Yemen. Sudan is also up there, depending on whether you count it MENA or not. Yemen, the plight in Yemen has become acute. Yemenis have about per capita access to water in Yemen is about 198 cubic meters. The World Bank places water scarcity at 1,000 cubic meters per person a year. So you can imagine what that means. So it's terrible. It's terrible for people, but it also, if you want to take a larger economic view, it is really bad for economic development. In fact, the World Bank thinks that water scarcity is going to knock down, is going to adversely affect the GDP of regional countries by about 14% over the next 30 years.
Right, staggering statistics and figures there. And do you think that the governments in the region are taking this seriously enough?
I think the governments in the region are taking it extremely seriously. The problem is, it's water scarcity. And the only thing that you can do is manage the resources that you have better. And I think some countries are doing that better than others. And I think this is where regional cooperation would be a good thing to have.
Right, of course. And there is a lot of war and conflict in this part of the world, sadly. How is that hampering efforts for countries and governments to work together and solve this common problem?
So you make a good point. Conflict is never a good starting point for cooperation. And you want to bear in mind that it isn't just regional conflict. It can be internal conflict as well. In Yemen, for example, you have an enormous amount of conflict because of the scarcity of the water. But then you also have larger, if not actual conflicts, you have countries being very wary of each other. The Turks and the Iraqis, Egypt's current strains, Egypt and Sudan's current strains with Ethiopia over the GERD, the Grand Ethiopian Renaissance Dam. It complicates matters enormously, particularly because the countries that need help the most are the countries that are in the worst positions often need help the most.
Israel, I mean, people here used to be obsessed with the water levels in the Kinneret, the Sea of Galilee. They've since developed this desalination technology, and they're now a world expert in that and are exporting their expertise to the region. Is this the future of solving the issue of water scarcity, do you think?
So you're quite right, of course. Egypt, Israel is a leader in desalination. But desalination, I mean, you think of it as a triangle, if you like. Desalination is only one leg of one corner of that triangle, mostly because desalination comes with its own set of problems. But what people should be looking at is desalination, should be looking at better use of existing resources, and it should be looking at developing plants and crops that are hardier and more resistant to droughts.
Right, a very worrying problem which affects all of us. Fascinating to talk to you, Miret Mabrouk. Thank you very much indeed.
My pleasure.